This video will review the latest clinical research in the treatment of degenerative meniscus tears and the biggest reason why you're going to want to treat a meniscus injury without surgery is because arthroscopic partial meniscectomies have been shown to increase your risk of getting worse arthritis in the future. Let's explore why. Hey everyone, Dr. Jeff Peng here. Now, if this is the first time you're watching one of my videos, my goal is to help each and every one of you live an active and healthy lifestyle. So if that's something you're interested in, please consider subscribing to my channel. I often give lectures to family medicine doctors in training, sports medicine specialists in training, and other practicing physicians. The following is a clip from a recent lecture that I gave examining a big shift in how we approach the treatment of degenerative meniscus tears. Okay, so we're going to be starting today's discussion on meniscus tears, and specifically what I want to talk about are degenerative meniscus tears. Now, this is very different from acute meniscus tears, right? So if you have an athlete, let's say it's a younger athlete, they plant, they twist, they feel a pop in their knee, it's swollen, you get an MRI, it shows they have a meniscus tear, right? Those people usually do better with surgery, and with surgery, they're trying to repair that meniscus. In these degenerative meniscus tears, these are usually in the population 40 years and older, right? So in terms of how we treat degenerative meniscus tears has really changed and shifted. Our mindset has shifted over the last few years. And in order to understand that shift, that change in concept of how we manage these, it's really important to first understand what are the meniscus, right? The meniscus are really cushions. They serve to help pad between the femur as well as the tibia. And they do also serve a smaller role in providing nutrients to the intra-articular space, but mainly their function is a cushion to help pad the knee. And so what happens when you have a meniscus tear, right? So in this picture, you have a flap tear. This is an arthroscopic view. You have the femur on top, the tibia on the bottom, and you can see the contours of that tear. And the theory behind this is, okay, if you have a tear in the meniscus is supposed to be smooth. So when you're rotating on a smooth surface, no problems, right? But if you have a tear and now you're rotating on that tear, well, every time you rotate on that flap tear, it's going to cause symptoms. It's going to cause locking. It's going to cause catching. It's going to cause what we thought was mechanical symptoms. And a lot of that is irritating. That leads to inflammation and leads to a lot of symptoms. And so what we used to do was, well, if there was a big tear there, let's go ahead and cut that out. That's what's called a total meniscectomy, where we cut the entire meniscus out. And what we found was that maybe that wasn't such the greatest idea, because what ended up happening, you cut the whole meniscus out. Well, what did you just do? You cut out that cushion. And when you lose that cushion, you started wearing down the cartilage in both the femur and the tibia. And that by definition leads to osteoarthritis. So then, you know, that's where we go back and revisit what is the purpose of the meniscus. The meniscus is a cushion. You cut out the cushion. Well, of course, you're going to lead to more wear and tear of your cartilage, and that's going to lead to arthritis. And so doctors started asking the question, well, okay, if you have a tear, what are we supposed to do with it? Can we now try doing an arthroscopic partial meniscectomy, where instead of opening the whole knee up, we stick a scope in and let's just clean up part of that tear? And since doing these surgeries, right, arthroscopic partial meniscectomies, 700,000 surgeries per year in the United States with a total estimated cost of up to $4 billion. And then the question we start asking is, do people actually see benefit with this procedure? Is this procedure better than not doing anything at all, right? Or does this procedure even work? And so this study was it was published in the New England Journal of Medicine. This was done in 2013, arthroscopic partial meniscectomy versus sham surgery for a degenerative meniscus tear. And what they did was they took hundreds of people, they stuck a scope inside their knee and confirmed, yes, a degenerative meniscus tear is present. Then they divided the patients in the operating room into two groups. One group ended up with the surgery. They got an arthroscopic partial meniscectomy where they go in, they clean up that meniscus. And then the other group got a sham surgery. And the sham surgery, they didn't do anything at all. They just got that scope stuck in their knee. They were moving the knee around. They kind of kept patients in the operating room for the same amount of time that the actual surgery would have taken. And what they found was, you can read their conclusion here, in this trial involving patients without knee osteoarthritis, but with symptoms of a degenerative medial meniscus tear, the outcomes after arthroscopic partial meniscectomy were no better than those after a sham surgical procedure. This was at 1 year. They go on to publish their 2-year follow-up results. At two-year follow-up, the outcomes after arthroscopic partial meniscectomy were no better than those after placebo surgery. No evidence could be found to support the prevailing ideas that patients with presence of mechanical symptoms or certain meniscus tear characteristics, or those who have failed initial conservative treatment, are more likely to benefit from arthroscopic partial meniscectomy. Now, it's really important that they... I want to point out that they mentioned the presence of mechanical symptoms or certain meniscus tear characteristics, because after this one-year follow-up study, right, a lot of surgeons started looking for other reasons to operate. And if you go back to mechanical symptoms, right, if you have that tear, people were like, well, as long as you have that tear, it's going to cause clicking, it's going to cause catching, it's going to cause locking of the knee. And as long as that tear is there, you got to do something about it. And so what this two-year follow-up study was looking at as well, turns out, even if you did have mechanical symptoms or other types of meniscus tear characteristics that surgeons were using as a reason to operate, they still didn't find benefit. And so since those studies have come out, more and more studies are looking at, are mechanical symptoms even attributable to meniscus tears? So the first one on top, this was a study in the British Journal of Sports Medicine published in 2019, Conundrum of Mechanical Knee Symptoms, Is This a Signifying Feature of a Meniscal Tear? The one on the bottom, published in the Journal of Bone and Joint Surgery in 2021, meniscal and mechanical symptoms are associated with cartilage damage, not meniscal pathology. And so both of these studies ended up with the same conclusion. Contrary to current dogma, traditionally defined meniscal and mechanical knee symptoms are strongly associated with the burden and severity of underlying cartilage damage rather than with specific meniscal pathology. So even mechanical symptoms or certain types of meniscus tear may not be a good reason for a surgeon to go in and try to do something, specifically try to shave it and clean up that meniscus tear. So that same study initially, that 1 in 2 year, the placebo surgery study, they actually published their results at 5 years. And this was published in the British Journal of Sports Medicine in 2020. And they go on to say that arthroscopic partial meniscectomy was associated with a slight increased risk of developing radiographic knee osteoarthritis and no concomitant benefit in patient-relevant outcomes 5 years after surgery. So not only is there no difference between getting an arthroscopic partial meniscectomy and a sham surgery, there's actually increased risk of getting the surgery. And we as doctors, right, we're taught do no harm first, do no harm. But now we have pretty good evidence that getting a partial meniscectomy can actually cause harm with no benefit to patient-relevant outcomes at 5 years post-surgery. So since that study has been coming out, more and more studies are looking at, oh my gosh, should we actually be doing arthroscopic partial meniscectomies? Let's do systematic reviews and meta-analysis to see if we can get a bigger N, right? We get more patients and see what the data shows. So this was published in the Clinical Journal of Sports Medicine, revisiting arthroscopic partial meniscectomy for degenerative tears in knees with mild or no osteoarthritis. This is a systematic review and meta-analysis of randomized controlled trials. And they essentially said, this systematic review and meta-analysis of high-quality literature provides relatively strong evidence that arthroscopic partial meniscectomy did not improve functional activity or reduce pain compared with the results with conservative treatment or sham operation in knees with mild or no osteoarthritis. Bottom line, maybe we shouldn't actually be referring all of these patients with meniscus tears for surgery. Maybe we should be trying other treatment options to treat their knees conservatively and trying all the other options to exhaust conservative measures, non-surgical treatment options, to get these people back to being physically active. So how are we supposed to treat this? If you got an MRI and it shows you got a meniscus tears, what are you supposed to do if physical therapy is not helping, if home exercise programs are not helping? What you really want to do is you want to treat the degenerative knee. You really want to treat that underlying osteoarthritis. That degenerative meniscus tear is a symptom of a bigger underlying problem, which is cartilage damage, which is the degenerative knee, which by definition is osteoarthritis. So this is what I show to all of my patients at every single appointment when I'm talking to them about osteoarthritis. We're looking over this, we're going over this, and specifically we're talking about injection therapy. And injection therapy we'll go over at another talk, and we'll specifically talk about visco supplementation later during this talk. And if you're interested in learning more about how to treat a degenerative knee, check out my video on how to treat knee arthritis without surgery. Thanks for watching.